quit my high paying job to become a full time freelancer, and in this video I will give you complete guide on how you can do the same. See, I used to travel daily 2 to 3 hours for my job and I hated it. And I wanted something that I could do from anywhere in the world, and I found freelancing. My freelancing journey was not straightforward. I failed a lot, but over the years I learned so many things, and in this video I want to compile everything at one place so that when you start your freelancing journey, you don't face the same mistake. So grab a pen and paper and start taking notes, and let's get started. So let's start by understanding the freelance game. Okay, so there is a person sitting across the world who has some kind of problem. A problem can be anything, such as he wants to build a logo, edit his video, build a dashboard, or it can be anything. Instead of hiring an employee that comes with a lot of overhead, he decides to hire a freelancer so he can just pay the money and get the work done. This is what the freelancing is all about. In this transaction, client will pay you money, and in the return of that, you will fix his problem. And the only way you can fix his problem is by if you really do the work, and for that you need skills. So the first thing in the freelancing is you need to acquire high paying skills. Here's the list of the high paying skills that pays really well in the market. Now, skills can be anything as long as you can complete the work. In my case, my skills were data engineering and web scraping, so I started with that. But remember, you are not doing freelance because you love the work. You are doing freelance to earn money. Always remember this, because most of the people have this confusion that should I pick data science, machine learning, data engineering, or this or that for freelance. Again, it does not really matter what skills you choose as long as you can complete the work. It does not have to be something that you really love working. All you need is one skill that can pay you money. The goal of your freelance journey at the start is not to love your work. The goal of your freelance journey is to start making money. So the first thing is you need to pick a skill. Now, if you don't have any skill set, then you can start by learning about or picking up the skills from the list that I gave you earlier. Pick one skill and start learning about it. In my case, I started with the data engineering because I already did few internships in my career, and I've done a lot of different courses that help me to learn about data engineering, data science, and machine learning. In your case, if you are a complete beginner, pick one skill that you think you can deliver the work, because this is what you are giving in the return of the money that you are getting. So no matter what skills you pick, always remember you should be able to do the work in the end. Now, once you learn all of these skills, then you need to have something that can showcase to the potential client. See, no one is going to give you the work just like that. You need to showcase that you can actually complete the work based on your past projects or the portfolio that you have. And if you don't have the portfolio, you have to build it. Client is sitting across the different side of the world. He got multiple freelancers reaching out to him. You need to convince him that you are the right person in this entire world who can actually do the work. And for that, you need to showcase that you have really done the similar work in the past. For example, let's say if you want to become a freelance data analyst. Now, in this case, you need to have like 2 to 3 good dashboards to showcase in your portfolio. You cannot convince someone just by telling them. You need to show something. So once you acquire your skill set, make sure you start working on building your portfolio. In my case, I had like 1 year of experience working as a job, and I did few internships. So I had few projects to put on my freelance portfolio. So I started with that. Even if you're a complete beginner, you don't really need the job experience. What you really need is the experience that showcases that you have done the similar work. So you can build a project by yourself and then put those projects on your portfolio. Now, once you build your portfolio, then you have to start reaching out and find the clients. Now, initially, if you don't have a personal brand or don't have a lot of experience, you can start with the freelancing platform. The two freelancing platforms that I suggest is Upwork and the Fiverr. These two platforms are really good. You can find a lot of problems and clients there and start making money. I also started my freelancing career with Upwork. So you can start your career with Upwork also. So you can go to this platform and start creating your profile. Now let me tell you this, just by creating your profile, you will not get any freelance work. This is where most of the people give up and get stuck. The reason is that a lot of people think that just by creating the profile, they will start earning money and get few clients. This is not how things work in the real world. Think about that. Just like you, there are thousands of people on this platform signing up right now. So the competition is always high. Even if you want to get a job or just want to buy a new iPhone, you will find the competition. So in order to beat the competition and stand out, you have to do a lot of work before reaching out to these clients. And this is all about understanding the game of Upwork. So when you create your new profile, let's say you start with the Upwork, your profile will nowhere near the perfect. So you will have to learn about the Upwork and how to create a good profile. Basically, you need to acquire the skill of Upwork, such as how to create a profile, what are the keywords that you have to include, how to put good image, and all of the other things. You need to learn these things about the platform before before you actually start reaching out to the potential client. Creating profile is not something that you get it done in 2 to 3 hours. It takes few weeks to have a good profile. So the one approach that I suggest is to go on Upwork and find the similar freelancer in your industry. So you can just search on the Google, such as data engineering freelancer on Upwork, and pick 4 to 5 profiles that is similar to your industries and start copy pasting stuff from there that matches your skill set. So this is the easiest way that you can build your profile and get started with the Upwork. Once you build your profile, then the next step is to start refining your skill set. This is what most of the video do not teach you online. You need to be a specialist in your particular industry. So in the first step, we pick the high paying skill set, such as data engineering or data science, machine learning, video editing, or it can be anything. Now the second step is to pick a niche in that industry. You can actually do the work and you become a specialist in that. So for example, if you are a data analyst, then you can be a Power BI expert or Tableau expert or dashboarding expert. You are a specialist on that one tool. So if a client who is looking to build a dashboard, and especially in the Power BI, he will reach out to you compared to all of the other people because you are a specialist in this industry or in that particular niche. So being a specialist will give you more work compared to being a generalist in that particular industry. So in my case, I was not a data engineer expert, but I was mainly around AWS and GCP expert, Airflow expert, or I was building a dashboard, so QuickSight or a Looker expert. So being an expert is really important compared to being a journalist in your industry. So when you are getting started, make sure you start with being an expert in that one domain and build your client base from that. So all of these things that you have done is just preparing yourself to be on this freelancing platform. Now this is the real game, which is applying for the proposal or applying for the jobs online. This is where the real freelancing game begins, because this is where you will find a lot of competition. The freelancer, just like you, trying to get the work and make money. So it is really important that you execute this particular step properly. Submitting proposal basically means client will have some kind of problem listed down on the Upwork or Fiverr. You send them proposal by stating that you are the right person to complete this job. And just like you, there will be hundreds of people doing the same. So how do you stand out? Now, you can always use the template available online, but this is not the right way to reach out to the client. You need to be personalized when you are applying for the job. Now, in the world of ChatGPT and AI, you can easily create the proposal within few seconds, but you need to sound like a human. You can't just copy paste the template from the ChatGPT and submit it on the Upwork profile. A client will know that you just copy pasted this stuff from the ChatGPT and he will completely ignore your proposal. So in my case, when I started posting the proposal, I submitted more than 100 proposals at my time and I did not get any work. The reason for that is that I was using template or I was not using the proper format that worked for me. This is one of the format that really worked for me, and this is the kind of the template that I use. Is I start with the directly giving the solution to the problem. This is what writing a good personalized proposal really mean. You have to start with the giving the solution. So client have a problem and you read the entire problem and give him the different solution that you can execute to fix this problem. So when you give the solution, client understands that you know what you are talking about and you have done the similar work in the past. This is basically where you build the trust and get the attention of the client. It is really important when you submit a proposal, the first thing you need to do is get attention from the client. He is getting more than 100 proposals. Your proposal will get lost if it is not properly crafted. So it is really important the hook of your proposal, which is the solution, should be good enough so that client can read your entire proposal and reply you back. So as you can see, in this job required to know about AWS, DynamoDB, Python and web scraping. In my proposal, I did not start talking about myself. Instead, I directly provided the complete solution to the problem at the start. This will build a trust in the client and he will understand that you really know what you're talking about. Again, you can use the ChatGPT and AI to build a proposal, but make sure you craft it in a way that looks personalized and a little bit with the human emotion so that client will understand that you actually wrote this proposal by yourself. So once you submit the proposal, that does not mean you will get the job. Just like you, as I told you, that there will be 50 to 100 people who will be applying for the same job, and there are high chances at the initial stage that your proposal will get lost, even if it like the best proposal in the world. The reason is that you are very new to the freelancing platform, or you don't have the good enough experience, and there might be a lot of other things that you might not know. Don't get discouraged, just move forward with the next client. In my case, I had to submit more than 100 proposals to get my first freelancing job. So if it happens to you, don't worry about it. Keep improving your profile. You will have to keep doing this thing again and again. It is pure hard work. It is boring, but you have to do this again and again. Do not get discouraged. Keep going forward, and one day you will get the reply from the client. And once you get the reply from the client, this is where the actual selling of yourself begins. So once you get the reply from the client, then you need to start communicating your skills and selling yourself in order to get the final work. Again, client will message 2 to 3 people, even more than that, just to understand who might be the best freelancer for his job. If you get this opportunity to sell yourself, you need to go all the way. You need to convince him that you are the best freelancer in this entire universe who can only solve his problem. This is the level of selling that you have to do to get the client. So get the client on the call and start talking about your skill set, how you can help him, and why you are the best person for this job. This requires good communication skill. You don't need to have like great communication skill set, but you need to have a decent communication skills where you can convince your message to the other person. So learning will not stop anywhere. You have to keep learning and improving at each and every stage of your life, from writing proposal, creating good profile, or selling a client. You have to learn each and every single component. This is the reason freelancing is easy, but it is very difficult to execute. Most of the people think that freelancing is all about you just submit the proposal, get the work, and you are done. It is not something like that. There's a high competition also, just like a job. They will test your skills and also how you behave in order to give you the final job offer. Same goes with the freelancing, but instead of just selling your skills, you have to sell the solution and more than that. Freelancing is about building a single person business, and it is really important that you know and have understanding about each and every part of the freelancing and you become master of it. I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just being an honest, because I have learned all of these things in my entire freelancing career. In the freelancing, you will never get the result on the next day. If you get it, you are lucky and you might have done the previous work. But most of the people, when they get started with the freelancing, just the average people, just like me, when I started with the freelancing, I did not have any skill set or anything to showcase. I had to learn and build my portfolio as I move forward and then start making the money. So one of the most difficult part of the freelancing is getting your first client. Once you get your first client, you will be set for next 2 to 3 years or even more than that, depending on how hard you work. So there's a one course that I launched around like 2 to 3 years back about freelancing when I just started my YouTube channel. This course is the ultimate course to give you the understanding of different parts of the freelancing in depth. So in this video, I just gave you the good overview, but if you really want to learn about all of these things, then I will put the link of the course in the description. I will make this course as affordable as possible. So this course will give you all of the tools that are required to start your career in freelancing, and then you can go on a journey to become a freelancer. So check the link in the description if you are interested enrolling in this course. Again, I will not guarantee that this course will help you to become a freelancer. There is no single course in this world that will guarantee you that you will get the freelancing job, but this course will give you all of the different tools and the skill set that you really need to become a freelancer. So I will highly encourage you to go and check this course out. So this was all about this video. If you really like this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more of this content. If you want to see more freelancing content, then let me know in the comments what you think about it, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.